7 o'clock, and at Carrow Road, the stage is set for the drama of Derby Day. In 6 hours' time, Norwich City kick off against promotion-chasing Ipswich Town, renewing a fierce rivalry that goes back over 50 years.
Good morning, for a start. You know what today is, the big one? Crowd expectations, 17,000 and 20,000. Away fans, we have 1,750.
High potential of outbreak of public disorder.
We will not be deflected from our task in policing this match in a firm and fair manner.
It's an all-seater stadium. We will discourage standing for the duration of the game. Firm, be fair, be positive in everything you do and polite at all times. Have a good afternoon.
For the 200 officers involved in policing the match, it means an early start. PC Keith Lambert has seen it all before. This will be his seventh local derby.
Who's going to score?
Dalglish is going to score two and Bellamy's going to score one.
Local derby, Norwich versus Ipswich. Norwich want Norwich to win and Ipswich want Ipswich to win, and this is the big one. You have to be there to believe it. Each set of supporters will get behind their team and they will shout and sing until they go hoarse, and the atmosphere will leave, your chest will vibrate and you'll just get carried away with the atmosphere.
In the past, that atmosphere has turned to violence many times. It's a pattern the police and the clubs are determined to break. During the week, Ipswich fanatic Steve Curtis is an insurance broker. Come the weekend, though, he proudly adopts the uniform of Burley's Barmy Army.
I work an office, so I have to be smart, wearing a suit, shave all the while, and at weekends I'm normally unshaven. But for football it's different. You have to be smart for the boys.
Back at Norwich Police Headquarters, it's breakfast time.
There you go.
Like all armies, this one marches on its stomach.
Did he trust us this morning?
Operation Bystander is about to kick off, the biggest police operation in the city for years.
We have a large number of officers on duty today, comprising 18 squads and, of course, the ancillary support, such as air, such as horses and British Transport Police. Briefings are as follows: 9:30 at the ground, that will be officers who are performing duty outside the ground.
Police reinforcements have been drafted in from Nottingham. Keeping the peace at derby matches calls for the occasional use of muscle, and on board these transporters, there's tons of it.
Saracen. He's about 9 years old, and he started off life as a show jumper. And now he's, well, one of the best horses we've got. People do tend to have a lot of respect. Probably more so for the horses than they do the officers.
The main train is, of course, the 12 noon arrival, the football special at Norwich Thorpe Railway Station. The intention will be to get those supporters via Lower Clarence Road and past the Clarence Harbour Public House straight into the ground.
Outside Portman Road, Ipswich supporters prepare to head up the A140 for what the clubs are calling the friendly derby.
We hate Norwich! We hate Norwich! We hate Norwich! We hate Norwich! We hate Norwich.
Every policeman will wear one of these on duty. Utility belt.
This 1 o'clock kick-off on a Sunday is an absolute joke.
One extendable truncheon.
They say that's to avoid trouble at a ground. This game could be played at 6 o'clock in the morning and there'd still be trouble.
All these lockers here contain CS spray. I've never had to use this since it's been out, but we do carry it in case of emergencies. And it's kept in the holster there.
I hope there won't be any trouble. I hope they're smashing of stands. But everyone knows it's going to happen. It's inevitable.
Two petrol bombs were handed to the police this week. They had just a bottle with a fuse in it and some stuff. It could have been petrol, could have been methylated spirits, that sort of colour. They were found. We don't know if there's anyone been in and hid any up. If you look, find an empty bottle, give it to us and we'll get rid of it for you. Because that could be the start of something. I'm not worried
yet. Inside Carrow Road, Colin Loveday and his stewards are the club's troubleshooters. It's their job to make sure everything goes smoothly and peacefully. There's no danger money, it pays £17 a match. For most, it's a labour of love.
Rain, shine, whatever, I'll still be down here, even if I didn't get paid.
It doesn't help with the attitude of certain stewards at Norwich City Football Club. They seem to want as much trouble as some of the fans. We get treated worse than animals.
Today, even the police helicopter makes the team sheet.
So we keep it about 1,000 feet. Only be about a 10-15 minute flight back here, cup of coffee, and then back up for about 10 to 12. For the 12 noon, where the majority of the fans are supposed to be on board. See them safely into the ground, let them see us, know that we're above them.
There's a strict booze ban on all trains, but where there's a will, there's a way. The football specialist due to leave Ipswich in 10 minutes. So far, the atmosphere's noisy, but friendly.
Morning, Ed. All right. Morning, all.
Traffic mainly using 22 and 27.
Roger, 22 and 27 in use, clear to start, corner alert, ready to lift, and police 26.
Come with the stretcher when you have a moment.
Go, 50 and 11, 30.
So much. Surface wind check for you, 20021.
They're anticipating 30 arrests.
Sit. This is police dog Caesar, who's been with us for 3 years now. And he's the one who went down London and bit the Prime Minister's wife and went down and got an award. Because I get excited because I'm a Norwich fan, so he gets excited as well, see.
To combat the traditional Derby Day hostilities, the two clubs have launched a campaign asking fans to shake hands on Derby Day. It's more in hope than expectation.
The organisers are saying, try and make it friendly between the fans. I mean, how possible is that?
Yeah! Shut it out! We hate Norwich! We hate Norwich! We hate Norwich! We hate Norwich! We hate Norwich!
I don't see a problem there.
I don't agree with all the violence, but I don't think you're ever going to get Norwich and Ipswich fans being friendly towards each other. It's just not, it's been like that for years. It's not going to change.
Oh, the derby makes it more important, but for once this year, promotion's the only thing we're really thinking of, so really 3 points is what matters. But it'd be nice to completely ruin their season at the same time, obviously.
There's no hatred, no hatred.
They shag their sisters.
For those who don't follow football matches, Norwich City are laying mid-table in the Division 1, and Ipswich are in second place, much as it hurts me to say that, and are going very much for promotion.
Always apprehensive, the yellow and green butterflies flickering away outside. But nice occasion, I hope it's going to be, that's what I must say. I feel good about our operation. I think our plans have gone fairly well. I think our teamwork is good with the police, so therefore I feel good.
Never felt more like singing the blues. Ipswich win, and Norwich lose, oh Ipswich.
Continue the large crowd. Stand still, stand still, stand still, stand still.
still a good girl.
Horses and riders are very effective but also very vulnerable to attack. If we need to deploy quickly, we need to move at a fairly fast rate of knots. We will give verbal warnings to people, and that is to any member of the public or to yourselves. And all I would say is if you hear a mounted officer give a verbal warning, then just step to one side.
Can we have Papa 6-2 to the rear of Lower Clarence, the rear of the railway station, ASAP?
Grudge match of the season, the Norwich Ipswich derby. 1 hour to kick off, and so far, so good. This police show of strength comes at a price. Operation Bystander is costing over £70,000. The club pays for policing in and around the ground, but the lion's share of the bill falls to the taxpayer.
Gentlemen, can I ask you to...
Keith Lambert is one of 200 officers on duty.
Some of your friends coming around the corner in blue shirts. I'm sure you'd like to meet them, wouldn't you?
Lovely.
Shake hands with them, wouldn't you?
We're not pretending that it's going to be a simple solution to some of the nasty element that creeps into these games. But what we are saying is that Ipswich Town and Norwich City play 23 games at home each year, and now 22 of them pass off very peaceably.
David, are you still in a position to offer me two stewards to go carry...
In the club's control room, this is an anxious period. The match is an all-ticket sellout, but getting the right bums on the right seats is easier said than done. They need eyes and ears everywhere.
There's something like 36 CCTV cameras, 16 are in the refreshment areas under the ground and places like that, and 20 in general, 20 cameras or so give us complete control of the ground and also the periphery outside the ground. That is invaluable.
Tickets are ready. Most important thing is ticket.
We're getting an increasing number of requests from Ipswich supporters who've bought tickets in the home areas and they want to transfer. These people know the rules of footballing. They should not buy tickets in the home areas.
Oscar to him.
Yeah, okay, Roger, over now. 20 minutes away from the kickoff control, I've just said there's 1,680 Ipswich fans in there, so they're getting out of capacity in there. And as you can feel the tension of the game is beginning to mount now, the adrenaline valves and Elliot are sort of maximum potential now, and we're in a derby day now, this is what football's all about.
It's all about that. It's not blue, it's about that. That's what it's about.
We've always been Ipswich, haven't we? But unfortunately, I met a Norwich supporter.
She didn't tell me she was Ipswich when I first met her.
Go! I must admit, I love to hate her.
As long as it keeps friendly all the way round, we have a good game and we'll go home happy.
It doesn't look right. Definitely doesn't look right.
We're the ones.
Who are you?
Sure, Victor 2. These people are coming into the F block. Do you know where they are at the moment, over?
We don't want to sit with them, we want to sit with our own lot.
Control Sierra Victor 2, we haven't brought them in yet.
Yeah, okay, Roger, over now.
Perfect scenario would be a 0-0 score. rain about 10 minutes before the end of the game, because that's the best policeman we have. But having said that, if things continue as they are, let's have a few goals, because the atmosphere is good and we welcome that as well. As long as everyone behaves themselves, we all go home happy, and that's what it's all about.
I'll keep your knees, so you can't sit, so you can't clap bitches. Who's going to win? You got to tell me Norwich is going to win before I take them off.
Say any dreams.
Say any dreams.
All units, last update message, approaching 19,000 in the ground. It's quiet outside, they are all in. Well done, keep it up now, let's have a good bit of safety management. We look forward to a good match. Oscar 2-8.
The supporters have gone in nicely, no trouble, absolutely brilliant at the moment.
After a friendly handshake from the players, the fans exchange the usual pleasantries.
Into the match.
We're
giving this, no one else is doing it, it's you. You are the only one giving it that. I'm watching you.
Oh, sorry.
It's a good day. Everyone's enjoying themselves.
No.
You're watching the match, giving it that.
Sorry.
Section 5 warning. Do it again, you're down the police room, all right?
Oh,
all right? Come on,
yeah,
enjoy
it.
I will. Scowcroft.
Come on, Johnson.
Now Johnson.
Oh,
and what would the collar of the card be for Matt Jackson, the Norwich skipper? This time the colour of the card is yellow. And Robert Green, who did well under a bit of pressure there. Vilnius 4, Ipswich. Here's Carey, now Bellamy. He's got Dalglish forward in support. Shot was drilled against Venus. Carey again, and here's Mulrein. Vilnius with the vital interception for Ipswich Town. Bellamy unable to get away from Venus. And there was a nasty challenge there by Craig Bellamy, who's been surrounded by Ipswich Town players.
Get a fucking drink, man!
Mickey Stockwell tried to calm the situation down. Mowbray decides to leave the free kick to Richard Wright, and it's a huge free kick to search out James Scowcroft. Here's Johnson. What a magnificent save by Robert Green.
That's it.
Game over. 0-0. For Ipswich, it's two very costly points lost in their push for promotion.
Watch your cameras, please.
In the control room, they've got the result they wanted. All that remains now is to see 19,500 people safely off the premises and on their way home.
We're going up, we're going up, we're going up, we're going up.
Norwich fans are allowed to leave immediately, while the visitors are held back. It's a tried and trusted way of keeping the rival factions apart. For this game, more than any other, segregation is paramount.
I don't know if the hooligan has gone out of the game, I hope it is, but I don't know. But today, no worries at all.
Disappointed we only got a point. And setting our performance, we deserved all three. The misses by Johnson were scandalous.
I'm very, very pleased for what we were trying to interpret this time with the shake hands on Derby Day, to kill a lot of the animosity that was between the rival fans. I've got to be very, very pleased.
Open the gates, repeat, open the gates. We thank you for your patience whilst being held back.
The exit gates to your right are now open. May I remind you that the 3:30 special from Thorpe Station
How come when Ipswich supporters come to Norwich they get treated like scum, yet when they come down to Ipswich they get a drink, they get a good welcome? That's just typical of the overreaction of the police today.
Victor three, coaches leaving now.
It's been done in a competitive spirit, but it's not been done in a destructive spirit. A tribute to both sets of supporters, they've behaved in a civilised way.
One group of Norwich supporters won't go home, causing Keith and his colleagues a few familiar problems.
These are our main hardcore supporters, the ones that come week in week intent on if there's a bit of trouble. Come on, mate, come on, hey. Come on, take me for a walk today, come on, Yota. Come on. Have we got a van, prisoner van? You've been told to go that way and you're looking for confrontation. You're going to get it.
There is no breach of the peace here. I live 30 yards down there.
You're going to sit there for half an hour and I'm going to kick you out, alright? He might live down there, he might not do. But we've arrested him to prevent the breach of the peace because he's not doing what we want him to do. He's trying to get to the railway station for confrontation and we've taken him out of the system now. He's going to sit in the van and cool off and he'll be let go. In half an hour's time, we'll back down at the police station when he's calmed down and the position is gone.
To the best of our knowledge, there's been two arrests, one outside Carrow Road and one arrest in the city centre, both immediately after the end of the game. So I think given the low level of damage, given the low level of arrests, given the low level of disorder in and around the ground and the city centre, we can all say it's been a very successful policing operation and an outstanding result.
Oh, what a day, what a day.
What a day.
Well done, boys.
Well done.
Easy.
Huh? Easy. That was never good as golf.
No problem at all.
We were on top of them, we outmanoeuvred them, and it's been a very successful day as far as Norfolk and Stanley are concerned.
Sierra Victor 2, sign off, whoever.
Roger, Sierra Victor 2, thanks, Colin.
Right, that's that. Finished.
Pub.
Point, I need a point.
With Ipswich missing out on promotion, the new season will see the old rivalry stirred up all over.